So hello students and welcome back to another video tutorial from Genome Biotech. And as always, I'm your host, Dr. Nitin Wahi. In this lecture, we would be talking about the vitamins, those organic compounds which are essentially required for the physiological functions of our body. So, and we would be classifying the vitamins into the water-soluble vitamins, the fat-soluble vitamins on the basis of their structure and composition. Then we would be looking at the different types of diseases as well as the questions which have been asked from this particular topic. So we have to finish this topic in this particular lecture only. So, okay. So in this lecture of biochemistry, we are starting the topic that is vitamins. Okay. So vitamins are basically organic compounds that are required by the body in traces amount to perform specific cellular functions. So these are the compounds that are being required in the body. These are firstly organic compounds. So the most important fact is this organic, these are all organic compounds in nature, and they are being required by the body in trace amount to perform specific cellular functions. Okay, so they are being required in trace amount to perform a specific function. So the first thing that the students gets confused is about this particular fact that these are organic molecules in nature. Okay, then the requirement of any given vitamin depends upon the organism. Not all vitamins are required by an organism. Vitamins are not synthesized by the humans. They are therefore necessarily required from the diet. So majority of the vitamins are not synthesized by humans. So majority of the vitamins are never being biosynthesized by the humans. In fact, these are being required. These are being required from the diet. That means these must be supplied from the diet, and from the diet one can utilize all these different vitamins. Vitamins ko aap diet se le sakte hain, and from the diet they are being absorbed. But there are three different types of vitamin. There are three different vitamins which can be biosynthesized either by the body or by the microbes that are being associated with the body. Okay, so I'm just writing it out here. There are three enzymes, there are three vitamins that can be biosynthesized by the body. One vitamin that is vitamin D or can be biosynthesized by the microbes present in symbiotic association with our body. Okay, and present in symbiotic association with our body, and those microbes include the bacterial species that could lead to the formation of vitamin B12, the causal vitamin for pernicious anemia, and vitamin K. So these are the two vitamins that can be biosynthesized in our body in the presence of the microbes. So the microbes have the ability to biosynthesize both of these vitamins in our body. Okay, is this clear? And our body can biosynthesize vitamin D. 24-25 dihydroxycholic calciferol, 125 dihydroxycholic calciferol, which is the active form of the vitamin D. We would be talking about all of these things. Okay, so now their vitamins can be classified in two different types, as it has been classified in Pathfinder. They could be fat soluble vitamins, they could be water soluble vitamins in nature. When you talk about fat soluble vitamins, as we all know, are the vitamins A, D, E, and K, are termed as fat soluble vitamins. All other vitamins are referred to as water soluble vitamin, except for vitamin C. The water soluble vitamins are all serving as the precursor of coenzyme. This point is also very important. Except vitamin C, all other vitamins serve as cofactor, as precursors for the different coenzymes. All of the other enzymes serve as coenzyme precursor, except the vitamin that is referred to as vitamin C. Vitamin C ko chhod de, except this vitamin C, all other will always work as a coenzyme precursor molecules. So this is very, very important. Okay, so we can just note it down, we can just write it down and have an understanding about them. So you can just note it down or copy this out, because this has also been asked. Except the vitamin C, all will serve as the coenzyme precursors. Now there are two conditions of metabolic disorders that can arise by the over uptake of the vitamins and the under uptake of the vitamins. One is condition is referred to as hypervitaminosis, and another one is referred to as hypovitaminosis. Now, what is this hypervitaminosis? And another one is hypovitaminosis. Now, in the case of hypervitaminosis and hypovitaminosis, what is being done? You just look here. Hypervitaminosis is a condition when the high amount of vitamins are present. Okay, then the condition is referred to as hypervitaminosis. Let me just put a note here. Vitamins deficiency and excess can both cause diseases. Vitamin deficiency as well as excess can both cause diseases, and thus vitamin deficiency as well as the excess can both cause diseases. Thus it leads to hypervitaminosis if accumulation occurs, or leads to specific disorders if some vitamins are absent. Vitamins are absent in adequate amount in diet. Okay. So if you are not going to take adequate amount of the vitamins in diet, then it will lead to certain disorders. But there are certain vitamins in which there can be hypervitaminosis. Now, what happens in the case of hypervitaminosis is that in the case of hypervitaminosis, you have very large amount of vitamins that have been accumulated in your body. Agar aapki body ke andar bahut zyada vitamin accumulate kar gaye hain, to us condition ko hum hypervitaminosis kehte hain. Okay. And if the less amount of vitamins have been uptaken in the diet, then it will lead to nutritional disorders. Okay. Note, this is very important. Water-soluble vitamins never undergo hypervitaminosis. Water-soluble vitamins never undergoes hypervitaminosis, as these will never undergo hypervitaminosis. Why they will never undergo hypervitaminosis? Because these are being excreted from the body. Okay, they will never undergoes hypervitaminosis, as these will be excreted out of the body. Okay, because these compounds are being excreted out of the body, because these are water soluble vitamins, na, they never undergo hypervitaminosis, as these will be excreted out of the body. So these are the most important vitamins that you can consume irrespectively to your body need. The excess vitamins will be deliberately excreted out of your body, and the useful ones will be uptaken and utilized in your body. Yani ki dekhiye, vitamin, water soluble vitamins, aise vitamins hai jinka kabhi bhi hypervitaminosis nahi hota. As they never undergo hypervitaminosis, then it becomes very clear that these molecules, these vitamins will never accumulate in the body. And even when you are going to take them in excess, then these will be excreted out of the body. Okay, so this condition is commonly referred to as hypervitaminosis. Okay, is this clear to you all? Okay, now see, that is why there are several different types of drugs, the Revital and other different types of energy boosting drugs, okay, that are being available in the market. They have very high amount of water soluble vitamins present within themselves. All these drugs have very, very high amount of water soluble vitamins present within themselves. Okay. Next. Now we would be classifying the vitamins. So you can just note down the classification of vitamin. All these things have to be noted down with along with me. Okay. Or you will get the recorded version of the lecture. There you can also note it down. Now you just look here. When we are going to classify vitamins from Lippincott, then you just see, we have made a a chart in which the vitamins have been classified into water soluble and fat soluble vitamins. Now, water soluble vitamins that are not a part of the B complex, there is only a single vitamin that is not a part of the B complex, and that is referred to as vitamin C. Okay, and here is the vitamin B complex. So this vitamin C will never participate in the formation of any coenzyme in any enzymatically catalyzed reaction. Of course, it could act as a cofactor molecule, but it will never act as a coenzyme. It will act never act as a coenzyme. It will act as a cofactor molecule in the enzyme catalyzed reaction by prolyl hydroxylase and lysyl hydroxylase. Okay, you know that vitamin C also has act as a cofactor. I would be talking about it. Now, vitamin B complex. Vitamin B complex can be categorized into three different types: energy releasing, hematopoietic, and others. Now, energy releasing. Now, which are these energy releasing compounds? The energy releasing compounds include thymine. Thymine, which is referred to as vitamin B1. Okay, this is thymine. Just a second. I'm not able to highlight it out. This is riboflavin. Then you have niacin, vitamin B3, biotin, pantothenic acid. Hematopoietic, that induces hematopoiesis. That induces blood formation in your body, that is referred to as folic acid as well as vitamin B. Both folic acid and vitamin B serve as hematopoietic vitamins. There are others which have certain minor functions. So we would be talking about all these different types of vitamins. First, we would be talking about the water soluble vitamins. Then we would be looking at the fat soluble vitamins. सबसे पहले हम water soluble vitamins के बारे में बात करेंगे. Then we would be talking about the fat soluble vitamins. Okay, so let us have a look at the chart which is being shown here. There is a chart which is being shown here. What does this chart say? ये chart क्या कह रहा है? What does this chart say? This chart speaks that how the nutritional anemia takes place. The nutritional anemia can be microcystic, it can be normocystic, it can be macrocystic. Okay, these are the three different types of anemia that can take place. And what does this happen? What happens with these anemia that we have to see? There is a deficiency of iron. There is a deficiency of copper. There is a deficiency of peroxide. Then it is referred to as microcystic anemia. Now, what happens in the case of microcystic anemia? The size of the RBC is drastically reduced. ये जो microcystic anemia होता है, इसके अंदर क्या हो जाता है? Size of RBC is drastically reduced. Size of RBC is reduced. When the size of the RBC is reduced, then the condition is referred to as microcystic anemia. Such type of RBCs will get destroyed in the spleen, and then it is referred to as microcystic anemia. Now you look here, normocystic anemia. In the case of normocystic anemia, there is a protein energy malnutrition disorder. Okay, so there is a protein energy malnutrition disorder, then it is referred to as normocystic anemia. This is normocystic. And the last one is referred to as macrocystic anemia. What do you mean by macrocystic anemia? In such type of anemia, there is either a vitamin B12 deficiency or there is a folate deficiency. Okay, then it is referred to as macrocystic anemia. In these type of anemia, the RBC size became much more larger. That means these are being released in the form of normocytes. Normocytes. If you know about how the life cycle of the RBCs, then you must know that normocytes are the RBCs that converts into pre-erythrocytes. And once the pre-erythrocytes are being produced, then these pre-erythrocytes get converted into erythrocytes. Okay? Erythrocytes. Ye pre-erythrocytes kis mein convert ho jate hain? Erythrocytes mein convert ho jate hain. Once they form erythrocytes, then they can be effectively entered into the bloodstream. And for that, they require two different vitamins. One is folate, another one is vitamin B12. If there is a deficiency, it will lead to macrocystic anemia. That is also referred to as a specialized anemia called as pernicious anemia with respect to vitamin B12. So please do remember this particular chart. This is highly important. You must remember this one. Is this clear? Now moving to the folic acid. Now, what does folic acid do? What happens with the folic acid? Okay. So folic acid is the one that helps in the translocation of one carbon metabolism. You know that there is a compound that is refer to as tetrahydrofolate. N5, N6, dimethyl tetrahydrofolate. Dimethyl tetrahydrofolate. This is a molecule that has the ability to transfer the methyl group. ये वो मॉलिक्यूल है जिसके अंदर एबिलिटी होती है मिथाइल ग्रुप को ट्रांसफर करने की. एंड इट इज दिस मॉलिक्यूल दैट कैन ट्रांसफर द मिथाइल ग्रुप फ्रॉम वन सबस्ट्रेट टू द अदर. सो दिस टाइप ऑफ रिएक्शन इज बीइंग कैटलाइज्ड बाय द वाटर सॉल्युबल विटामिन. द विटामिन कंपोनेंट दैट इज रेफर टू एज द फोलिएट, ऑल्सो रेफर टू एज फोलिक एसिड. इट इज कॉमनली रेफर टू एज विटामिन एम. इसका ही दूसरा नाम है, दैट इज रेफर टू एज विटामिन एम. Okay, now what does this vitamin do? It is being involved in the transfer of a carbon atom, and the transfer of carbon atom takes place. Just a second. It is involved in the transfer of the carbon atoms, and as the transfer of the carbon atom is going to take place, this is going to transfer that particular carbon atom in the form of a methyl group from one reactant to another. So one carbon metabolism is the process that is being catalyzed by the folic acid. Tetrahydrofolate, that is reduced folate, receives one carbon fragment from donor such as serine, glycine, histidine, and transfer them to the intermediate in the synthesis of amino acid purine as well as pyrimidine found in DNA. Now see this, folic acid is a very important component that is involved in the purine as well as pyrimidine biosynthesis. Purine or pyrimidine ki de novo biosynthesis ke liye folic acid ek bahut hi important intermediate hai. It catalyzes de novo biosynthesis. Okay, de novo biosynthesis. Now what do you mean by de novo biosynthesis? De novo biosynthesis means synthesis from the components. There are two different types of biosynthesis in biological world. One is called as de novo, another one is called as salvage. When you talk about the salvage pathway, means you are utilizing the breakdown products and then you are manufacturing certain things. Okay, then it is referred to as salvage. Salvage ka matlab kya hota hai? Salvage ka matlab hota hai jab aap kisi cheez ke breakdown ke products ko, maan lijiye aapne khana khaya. अब भैया आपने जो खाना खाया है उसके अंदर भी तो न्यूक्लिक एसिड होगा. इफ यू हैव कंज्यूम्ड फूड देन दैट फूड विल आल्सो हैव न्यूक्लिक एसिड. नाउ यू कैन मेटाबोलाइज दैट न्यूक्लिक एसिड एंड यूटिलाइज दैट न्यूक्लिक एसिड फॉर योर ओन सेल्फ. देन सच टाइप ऑफ पाथवे इज रेफर्ड टू एज साल्वेज पाथवे. आप न्यूक्लिक एसिड को मेटाबोलाइज करेंगे और अपनी बॉडी में यूज करेंगे, देन सच टाइप ऑफ पाथवे दैट इज प्रेजेंट इज कॉमनली रेफर्ड टू एज द साल्वेज पाथवे. But here, what we are going to do, here we are going to perform the de novo pathway. Now, what is this de novo pathway? De novo pathway means to biosynthesize something new. De novo pathway ka matlab kya hai? Kisi cheez ko naya banana. Okay, so if you have to make something new, that is if you have to perform purine or pyrimidine nucleotide biosynthesis, then you require essentially the folic acid. Those who were in my class, in my previous classes, those who have seen how the purine and pyrimidine nucleotide biosynthesis takes place, they must have remembered the compound tetrahydrofolate. This compound was serving as the methyl group donor in several different types of biochemical reactions. Okay. Now moving forward, what happens in the case of folate and how nutritional anemia is being caused? So anemia is a condition when the blood has a lower than normal concentration of hemoglobin. Now, this folate is responsible for the maturation of the RBCs, for converting the normocytes, the large RBCs, into actual erythrocytes, the small RBCs lacking a nucleus. In the normocytes, there is a nucleus which is present. Normocytes have a very well-defined nucleus, and they have several different types of organelles and other different things present. The normocytes kuch is tarike ka hota hai. This is how normocyte is being arranged. And then it gets converted into erythrocytes. Okay. Yes, there is a question. Sir, both pathway exist, only nucleic acid and it involves protein and fat. Yes. So this folate is being required for both the pathways, whether it is nucleic acid, whether it is your proteins or any other things. Everything requires folate. And this de novo pathway is present only for de novo pathway that you were visualizing now, that de novo pathway was present only for the metabolism of the folic acid. ठीक है, फोलिक एसिड का यूटिलाइजेशन केवल डी नोवो पाथवे में ही होता है. देखिए यहाँ पर देखेंगे अनीमिया के अंदर क्या हो जाता है, आरबीसी ऑक्सीजन को नहीं लेके जा पाते क्योंकि उनके अंदर हीमोग्लोबिन की कमी हो जाती है. इन द केस ऑफ अनीमिया द नंबर ऑफ आरबीसी ड्रास्टिकली रिड्यूसेस, दे आर नॉट एबल टू कैरी द एडिक्वेट अमाउंट ऑफ ऑक्सीजन टू देयर टारगेट साइट एंड दिस लीड्स टू डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ अनीमिया. For example, microcystic anemia takes place in the deficiency of iron, whereas macrocystic anemia takes place in the deficiency of both vitamin B12 or in the deficiency of folate. Okay, so they causes anemia. Now, this is very important. You just remember this particular diagram. Now, you know that folate is required for amino acid biosynthesis. It is being required for protein biosynthesis. It is being required for thymidine monophosphate biosynthesis. Folate ka requirement hai bhai amino acid ko banane ke liye. क्योंकि अमीनो एसिड में भी मिथाइल ग्रुप को ट्रांसफर करना पड़ता है, मिथाइल ग्रुप को ट्रांसफर करना पड़ता है प्यूरीन की बायोसिंथेसिस के अंदर और थायमिडीन मोनोफॉस्फेट की बायोसिंथेसिस के अंदर. सो फोलेट इज एन इंपॉर्टेंट कंपाउंड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ टेट्राहाइड्रोफोलिक एसिड, टेट्राहाइड्रोफोलेट दैट इज बीइंग एसेंशियली रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द बायोसिंथेसिस ऑफ ऑल द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ इंटरमीडिएट्स, वेदर इट इज अमीनो एसिड, वेदर इट इज प्यूरीन और वेदर इट इज थायमीन monophosphate. So all of these molecules require the folic acid. Okay, now the folic acid that is being required, it requires an enzyme that is referred to as dihydrofolate reductase. It requires an enzyme that is referred to as dihydrofolate reductase. And this dihydrofolate reductase is involved in the formation of tetrahydrofolic acid. So dihydrofolate reductase is involved in the formation of tetrahydrofolic acid. Ab yahan dekh sakte hain beta ek enzyme hai jo uska naam hai dihydrofolate reductase. Ye tetrahydrofolic acid ko banata hai. So this enzyme is being inhibited in the presence of a compound that is referred to as methotrexate. Methotrexate will inhibit this particular enzyme that is referred to as dihydrofolate reductase. Okay, so it will act as a competitive inhibitor. For this particular enzyme. Okay, so this is a chemical that acts as a competitive inhibitor for dihydrofolate enzyme. Okay, so methotrexate will act as a competitive inhibitor to it. So this is very important. This question has been asked. There is another compound that is referred to as dihydropitrate synthase. And this dihydropitrate synthase is being inhibited by sulfonamides. These are commonly referred to as sulfa drugs. So dekhiye, do tarike ki drugs hain jo inhibit kar deti hain folate ke metabolism ko. There are two different types of drugs that will inhibit the folate metabolism. These two drugs are the sulfonamides and the methotrexates. Okay, and these drugs will act in different manner. ये दोनों अलग-अलग तरीके से work करती हैं. Sulfonamide will inhibit the absorption of folic acid, and methotrexate will inhibit the utilization of folic acid in its active form, that is tetrahydrofolic acid. देखिए sulfonamide folic acid को absorb नहीं होने देगा फूड मटेरियल से, और मेथोट्रेक्सेट फोलिक एसिड को अपनी एक्टिव फॉर्म में कन्वर्ट नहीं होने देगा. बोथ ऑफ दीज आर बीइंग यूज्ड एज अ कंट्रोलिंग एजेंट्स, आर बीइंग यूज्ड एज अ ड्रग इन द ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ न्यूओप्लास्टिक डिसीजेस. नाउ व्हाई न्यूओप्लास्टिक डिसीजेस? न्यूओप्लास्टिक डिसीजेस मींस कैंसर. न्यूओप्लास्टिक डिसीज का मतलब ही बेटा कैंसर से है, बिकॉज इन द केस ऑफ कैंसर द rate of biosynthesis of nucleic acid is greatly increases. Okay, so if you treat the cancer cells with methotrexate, then they will not have the amount of folic acid to synthesize purine molecules. Folic acid unke andar nahi jayega, purine ka molecule biosynthesize nahi hoga. A folic acid analog is used to treat fibrosis, rheumatoid arthritis and neoplastic diseases. Okay, there is another compound, the sulfa drugs, also referred to as the sulfonamides. So when you use sulfa drugs, drugs or you use sulfonamide, then these sulfa drugs or sulfonamide will inhibit the enzyme that is referred to as dihydropetroate synthase. They will be inhibiting this particular enzyme, dihydropetroate synthase. Once they will inhibit this particular enzyme now, then the entire procedure for folic acid absorption is not going to take place. So either you inhibit the folic acid absorption in the case of microbes through sulfa drugs, or in the case of humans as well as microbes, the methotrexate will act and it will inhibit its interconversion into tetrahydrofolic acid. Is this clear? Bhaiya, clear hai ki nahi hai? Pehle ye batao. Is this clear to you all not? So see this. This is the inhibition point here. This is the inhibition point here. Any doubt you have, you can ask me. Because see, every year one question arises from this particular chart. Bhai, har ek saal mein ek question yahan se aana hi aana hai. So this is very important. Is this clear to you all or not? Or should I ask you by your name? Achal, Neharika, Ankit, Anrudh, Rudra, Heba, Neharika, Priyanka, Rashi, Shivani, Shubhangi, Suryansh, Yogesh. Is this clear? Any doubt? Anyone has any doubt? Now you just ask me. You just raise your hand and ask me. Okay? Okay. So next. So this is all about the folic acid. At the end of the chapter, I will again revise you up with the with a chart that you can copy, or you would be provided the chart in the group by itself. Okay, so this is all over. This is an important figure that has to be remembered. Now, moving forward to the next point, you can see these are the different cells that have been enhanced in their size has taken place, and then they would be destroyed very soon in the case of spleen. Now another that is referred to as cobalamin. Cobalamin that is referred to as vitamin B12. Okay, this is what was also given in your pathfinder about the folic acid. Let us also look at pathfinder. In the pathfinder also there are certain points which are given, but these points in pathfinder are very limited. That is why I am not of the view that I should read pathfinder for this particular topic. Very little information is provided in pathfinder about vitamins. Just a second. Can we have folic acid? Okay, this is just a second. Just a second, beta. Moving to the other page. So here is the folic acid that is present. Folic acid is composed of a pterin ring. So a pterin ring is present, which is attached to the para-amino benzoic acid. So these are the two compounds that are present. So this is the pterin ring, and this pterin ring is being attached to the para-amino benzoic acid in the case of pathfinder. It is given. This is the PABA, para-amino benzoic acid, that is present, and this is the glutamate. Okay. Then folic acid is present in its active form in the form of tetrahydrofolate. I have already told you it is involved in the carboxylation reaction, that is one carbon transfer reaction. Its deficiency leads to megaloblastic anemia. I have already told you that. Okay, so that is the only thing that is given. But the two drugs which are very important are methotrexate and the sulfonamides. Okay, moving back to pathfinder. Now we are talking about the enzyme, the vitamin that is referred to as vitamin B12. Ab hum jis vitamin ke bare mein baat karne wale hain, us vitamin ka naam hai vitamin B12. Now how does vitamin B12 works, and what is the actual function of this vitamin B12? So vitamin B12 in humans serves two essential enzymatic reactions, and those two essential enzymatic reactions are the remethylation of homocysteine to methionine. So the interconversion of homocysteine to methionine, that is methionine biosynthesis, is being catalyzed by cobalamin. Okay, and the isomerization of methyl malonyl coenzyme A, that is produced during the degradation of some amino acids and fatty acid with odd number of carbon atoms. So all these things are being performed by vitamin B12. Okay, you can look at the reactions that are being shown to you. You can look here. Methyl malonyl coenzyme A, vitamin B12 is present, and it is this vitamin B12 that convert methyl malonyl coenzyme A into succinyl coenzyme A. Methyl malonyl coenzyme A succinyl coenzyme A mein convert ho jata in the presence of the vitamin B12. Homocysteine can get transformed into methionine, that is vitamin B12, serve as an important component in the biosynthesis of methionine. So vitamin B12 will inhibit the biosynthesis of methionine from homocysteine. Okay. Now, two important points that are very important for the cyanocobalamin or cobalamin vitamin B12, that is the ring-shaped structure. This is the only vitamin that has a corine ring system present within itself. These are the corine rings which are present. Instead of the methylene bridges, it just have a single carbon atom present in between the corine ring. Corine ring ke beech mein keval ek single carbon atom hi present hota hai. There is a cobalt molecule that is present, and this cobalt molecule is being coordinated from all the six different sites. Cobalt ka molecule 6 sites se coordinated hota hai, and this is referred to as cyanocobalamin. Okay, methyl cobalamin, 2-deoxyadenosylcobalamin. These are the different types of group. Now, whether it is cyanide group is being attached, then it is referred to as cyanocobalamin. Methyl group is being attached, it is called as methylcobalamin. 5-deoxyadenosylcobalamin. If 5-deoxyadenosine is being attached, it is called as 5-deoxyadenosylcobalamin. So these are the different groups which are being involved. Okay. So this is the structure of vitamin B12 that is being involved and its cofactor. Distribution of cobalamin. Now, this is very important. देखिए ये बड़ा important है, आपको ये याद करना है. You have to memorize this out. This is very, very important. Very important. Now, you know that vitamin B12 was also referred to as Castile intrinsic factor. Now, what is this Castile intrinsic factor? Actually, there are cells which are present in the stomach, and those cells are referred to as the parietal cells. These parietal cells have the ability to biosynthesize the intrinsic factor. Once the intrinsic factor is being biosynthesized, vitamin B12 binds to this intrinsic factor. Once it binds to the intrinsic factor, now it is being absorbed by the mucosal cell lining of the small intestine ileum, and then it moves into the bloodstream. So blood ke andar vitamin B12 ke absorption ke liye kya chahiye? You require a factor being secreted by the parietal cell, and the factor that you require is referred to as the intrinsic factor. The most important factor that you require is intrinsic factor. This is the most important factor. Then it will bind and will cause the will facilitate the absorption of the vitamin B12 into the intestinal lumen and then into the bloodstream. Okay, into the blood. This is how the process takes place. Now, what happens? There is also a hypothesis that has to be remembered. One is referred to as the foliate trap hypothesis. What do you mean by the foliate trap hypothesis? देखिए एक hypothesis यहाँ पर दी गई है, जिसका नाम है foliate trap hypothesis. Now, what do you mean by foliate trap hypothesis? So, see this. If vitamin B12 cannot be biosynthesized and utilized, then it causes foliate accumulation in the body, and that is called as foliate trap hypothesis. How? The effect of cobalamin deficiency are most pronounced in rapidly dividing cell, such as erythropoietic tissues, the bone marrow, the mucosal cells. Such tissues need N5N10 methylene to form N10 formyl tetrahydrofolate. Now, such type of tissues needed N5N10 methylene to form N10 formyl tetrahydrofolate molecules. Okay. In the vitamin B12 dependent methylation of homocysteine to methionine is impaired because the methylation form cannot be converted directly to form another form of tetrahydrofolate. Folate is trapped in N5 methyl form. Now see this. If there is a deficiency of vitamin B12, मान लीजिए अगर किसी person के अंदर vitamin B12 की deficiency हो गई. In vitamin B12 deficiency, the utilization of N5 methyl form of tetrahydrofolate in the B12 dependent methylation of homocysteine to methionine is impaired. That means the process of methylation is going to be impaired. How the process of methylation is going to be impaired? Please look forward. Methylation ka process kis tarike se impaired ho jayega? Hame ye dekhna hai. See this. This is the process of methylation that is going to take place. Now, supposingly, if there is a mutation, there is a deficiency which is going to take place. Agar yahan par maan lo ki koi deficiency ho jati hai, If there is a deficiency that is going to take place at this particular site, at this particular site, there is a deficiency or blockage, then vitamin D will accumulate. It will not allow the formation of tetrahydrofolate. Then tetrahydrofolate will get entrapped in the form of N5-methyl tetrahydrofolate molecule. Ye entrapped ho jayega kiski form mein? N5-methyl tetrahydrofolate ki form mein. This N5-methyl tetrahydrofolate is going to be increased in amount. As this N5-methyl tetrahydrofolate is going to be accumulated in the blood and it is going to be increased in amount. So this will get accumulated in the entire body. And this hypothesis is called as folate entrap hypothesis. Okay, is this now clear to you? Nahi samajh mein aaya to ab main Hindi mein samjha raha hu, Hindi mein samajh lijiye. Now try to understand in Hindi also. Dekhiye, vitamin B12 kya karta hai? Vitamin B12 wo vitamin hai jo cysteine ko methionine mein convert kar raha hai. So you look here. In vitamin B12 deficiency, the utilization of N5 form of tetrahydrofolate in the vitamin B12 dependent methylation of homocysteine to methionine is impaired. Utilization nahi ho pata N5 methyl tetrahydrofolate ka. Aur jab N5 methyl tetrahydrofolate ka utilization nahi ho pata, to ye accumulate karta hai. Aur accumulate karke body ke andar accumulate karta hi chala jata hai. Body ke andar ikhatta hi hota chala jata hai. And this leads to a hypothesis that is referred to as the folate trap hypothesis. So folate gets trapped in your body if you are not taking adequate amount of vitamin B12. Or folate trap ho gaya, to folate ki cycle chalegi nahi, uski bhi deficiency ho jayegi. Thus, cobalamin deficiency is hypothesized to lead to a deficiency of tetrahydrofolate. Dekhiye, so cobalamin, yani ki aapke vitamin B12 ki deficiency agar hoti hai, to aisa lagta hai ki tetrahydrofolate ki bhi deficiency ho gayi hai, and thus it will inhibit purine as well as thymine monophosphate synthesis, leading to megaloblastic anemia. So it will lead to a condition of megaloblastic anemia. Even if vitamin B12 is deficient, then it will lead to folate deficiency spontaneously. Vitamin B12 kam banaye, apne aap hi folate ki deficiency cause kar dega. Any doubt you have, you can ask me. Okay, moving forward. Now, vitamin B12 causes the pernicious anemia, causes megaloblastic anemia, and most important point, folic acid can partially reverse the hematological abnormalities of the vitamin B12. So if you are going to take folic acid in large amount, or you are going to take the other active form of the folic acid, that is tetrahydrofolate, then it will reverse the entire procedure. अगर आप टेट्राहाइड्रोफोलेट ले लेंगे या फोलिक एसिड को लार्जर अमाउंट में ले लेंगे, then the entire procedure of vitamin B12 deficiency will be reverted back. That means, what will happen? Then there will be no deficiency to take place. Thus, therapy of megaloblastic anemia is often initiated with folic acid and vitamin B12 until the cause of the anemia can be determined. So before determining the anemia cause, you have to use the vitamin B12 as a supplement in order to treat, you have to use folic acid as a supplement in order to treat the vitamin B12 deficiency. Yani ki vitamin B12 ki deficiency ko aap treat karte hain folic acid ko deke. Any doubt you have, you can ask me. This is clear to everyone. I should move forward. Then the next is referred to as the ascorbic acid. Ascorbic acid, which is also referred to as vitamin C. It is a non-coenzyme water-soluble vitamin. The only water-soluble vitamin which is not a coenzyme is vitamin C. ये केवल एक water-soluble vitamin है, जिसके अंदर vitamin C जो है, वो coenzyme नहीं होता. It do not serve as a coenzyme precursor molecule. Okay? Now, what we have to study is, so where is this vitamin C function? So ye vitamin C kahan par function karta hai, kya hota hai, what is this vitamin C and what are its likely functions? How does it perform the different functions that we will have to visualize? So vitamin C is also referred to as the ascorbic acid. In the entire biological world, there are only three acids that lacks the carboxylic group, but they are still organic acid. Those acids include ascorbic acid, picric acid, as well as the third one, which is referred to as the salicylic acid. Okay, look at the structure of vitamin C. Where is its structure? Probably somewhere here. Okay, so this is the structure of vitamin C. Just look at its structure. When you will look at its structure, there is no carboxylic group. Okay, so this vitamin also lacks a carboxylic group. Similarly, there are three others that lacks carboxylic group. Which are those three others? Three biomolecules, three acids, three organic acids lacks COOH group. These includes ascorbic acid or the picric acid, which is referred to as 2,4,6 trinitrophenol, or the salicylic acid. Please do excuse me for my spellings. They are pathetic. Okay. So salicylic acid. This salicylic acid will lead to the formation of 2-acetoxybenzoic salicylic acid, that is referred to as aspirin. Okay. It will lead to the formation of aspirin. So these are the one that lacks a carboxylic group present over themselves. So this question has been asked. I have already told you. Sorry. Now moving forward. Okay, this is what we fixed. So now moving forward, we are moving towards the vitamin C. Just clearing all the annotations. Clearing all the drawings. Now vitamin C. Vitamin C is involved in the hydroxylation of proline and lysine residue of the collagen. You can see at page number 47 that how does this reaction takes place. Okay, you can see this. This hydroxylation of the collagen is taking place in the presence of the vitamin C. Yahan par do enzyme hote hain beta, prolyl hydroxylase or lysyl hydroxylase. Both of the enzymes, prolyl hydroxylase as well as lysyl hydroxylase, causes hydroxylation reaction. You can look here. See this. In the case of collagen, there are three amino acids, glycine X and Y, where X is referred to as prolyl hydroxylase and Y is referred to as lysyl hydroxylase. Both of these enzymes, whether it is prolyl hydroxylase or whether it is lysyl hydroxylase, will always utilize four cofactors for their activity. The four cofactors which are being utilized for their activities include the following. Okay, both these enzymes require four cofactors. Both prolyl hydroxylase and lysyl hydroxylase, both prolyl hydroxylase and prolyl and lysyl, L-Y-S-Y-L, hydroxylase enzyme uses four cofactors. And those four cofactors which are being included are alpha-ketoglutarate, alpha, I cannot add alpha here, so I will have to write it, alpha-ketoglutarate, oxygen molecule, Fe2 positive ions, okay, as well as vitamin C, as well as the vitamin C, which is commonly referred to as the ascorbic acid. So both of these molecules utilize all these four different types of cofactors. So these four cofactors are essentially being required in the entire metabolic reactions. If these four cofactors will not be present, then there will be no hydroxylation and the chains will not be able to strengthen themselves. This is a, what do you mean by collagen? Collagen is the largest, the most abundant extracellular protein present in vertebrates. It consists of three tropocollagen molecules wrapped around each other, which are being held together with the help of hydrogen bonds in between the hydroxylic groups. Collagen ke structure ki maintenance ke liye hydrogen bonds sabse important hai. And hydrogen bonds are present in between hydroxylic groups of prolyl hydroxylase and lysyl hydroxylase. If the hydrogen bonds cannot be produced, agar hydrogen bond effectively nahi bane, तो कोलाजन ब्रेक हो जाएगा बच्चों। ये अगर कोलाजन ब्रेक हो जाएगा then there would be clotting taking place in the entire body। जहां से आप बॉडी को टच करोगे वहीं से बॉडी के अंदर से ब्लड निकलने लग जाएगा। इफ यू विल टाइट योर फिस्ट, अगर आप अपनी मुट्ठी बंद करेंगे तो वहीं से आपकी स्किन फट जाएगी और ब्लड बाहर निकलने लग जाएगा इफ देयर वुड बी अ डेफिशिएंसी ऑफ द कोलाजन। ओके, सो नाउ मूविंग बैक टू दैट पर्टिकुलर पॉइंट, यू कैन लुक हियर, दिस इज हाउ द डेफिशिएंसीज एंड द क्लिनिकल सिम्टम्स। विटामिन सी एस्कॉर्बिक एसिड डेफिशिएंसी विल लीड टू स्कर्वी, आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू। Then the next is referred to as the pyridoxine, which is also referred to as the vitamin B6. Now, how does vitamin B6 act and in which manner the vitamin B6 act? That we have to see. Vitamin B6, which is also referred to as pyridoxine, it is involved in different types of reactions, catalyzing the transfer of amino group from one substrate to another. That is, it is involved in the case of transamination reaction. ये ट्रांसमिनेशन की रिएक्शन के अंदर इन्वॉल्व होता है, अमीनो ग्रुप को ट्रांसफर कर देता है एक मॉलिक्यूल से दूसरे मॉलिक्यूल पे। इट इज द वन दैट इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द ट्रांसफर ऑफ द ग्रुप फ्रॉम वन मॉलिक्यूल टू द अदर, देन इट इज कैटलाइजिंग द ट्रांसमिनेशन रिएक्शन। अल्फा कीटो ग्लूटरेट गेटिंग कन्वर्टेड, ऑक्सलोएस्टेट ग्लूटामेट गेटिंग कन्वर्टेड इनटू एस्पार्टेट एंड अल्फा कीटो ग्लूटरेट, दिस इज हाउ द रिएक्शन इज टेकिंग प्लेस। ओके, देन pyridoxine forms a shifts base with the transaminase enzyme. Okay, so in its absence transamination is not going to take place. It is involved in the formation of delta aminolevulinic acid, which will serve as an intermediate for the biosynthesis of hemoglobin, myoglobin as well as chlorophyll rings. Yahan par ये बनाता है एक कंपाउंड को जिसका नाम है डेल्टा अमीनोलेविलिनिक एसिड, और ये तीन कंपाउंड्स बना देता है। इट विल लीड टू द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ पोरफायरिन रिंग ऑफ हीम, पोरफायरिन रिंग ऑफ हीम, ऑफ हीमोग्लोबिन, ऑफ मायोग्लोबिन और ऑफ क्लोरोफिल, क्लोरोफिल। सो ऑल दीज मॉलिक्यूल्स will be biosynthesized from this particular compound which has been biosynthesized by the use of vitamin B6. Now, what does vitamin B6 do in the case of transamination reaction? That we have to see. Okay? Where it is? Just a second, beta. Transamination. This is what happens in the case of transamination. Just a minute. If I can have that particular reaction, I can show it to you. Most probably, I will have it. Yes. Now, see this. These are the transaminase enzymes. This is how pyridoxal pyrophosphate works. So, pyridoxal pyrophosphate has an ability. It has an ability in order to ट्रांसफर द अमीनो ग्रुप। एक अमीनो एसिड से अमीनो ग्रुप को ले लिया है और इस अमीनो ग्रुप को दूसरे कीटो एसिड पे ट्रांसफर कर देंगे। सो यू कैन लुक हियर दैट द ग्लूटामेट डोनेट्स इट्स अमीनो ग्रुप एंड इट ट्रांसफर द अमीनो ग्रुप टू द ऑक्सलोएस्टिक एसिड फॉर्मिंग एस्पार्टेट। सो ऑक्सलोएस्टिक एसिड इज गेटिंग कन्वर्टेड इनटू एस्पार्टेट एंड ग्लूटामेट इज गेटिंग कन्वर्टेड इनटू अल्फा कीटो ग्लूटामेट। Such type of enzyme is referred to as transaminase. Transaminase is an enzyme that leads to the biosynthesis of the interconversion of an amino acid into a keto acid and a keto acid into an amino acid. जब एक keto acid amino acid में बदल जाए और एक amino acid keto acid में बदल जाए, तब उस reaction को हम बोलते हैं transamination की reaction, और इसे catalyze करने वाला जो enzyme है, the enzyme that catalyzes this reaction is referred to as pyridoxal phosphate. Okay, so this is pyridoxamine, which is present, which is commonly referred to as the vitamin B6. Okay, so moving to the concern page 378, just let us finish this topic. So this is all about pyridoxine. Next is thymine. Thymine refers to the vitamin B1. Now, vitamin B1 is referred to as thymine. in the absence of the thiamine, those who are alcoholics and takes excess amount of alcohol in their body, there is a deficiency of vitamin B1, thiamine taking place. Okay, agar koi bahut zyada absorb karta hai, bahut zyada consume karta hai alcohol ko, to alcohol inhibit kar deta hai thiamine ke absorption ko. Aur thiamine bahut hi important compound hai pyruvate dehydrogenase complex ki reaction ke andar, and thus the reaction of the pyruvate dehydrogenase complex will be halted, and such type of condition is called as Wernicke-Korsakoff syndrome. Please let me write this point here. Thiamine, alcohol inhibits the thiamine absorption in the intestine, as it will not be absorbed. So it will not be able to serve as a cofactor in the enzyme catalyzed reaction of the pyruvate dehydrogenase complex, thus inhibiting the complex and leading to deficiency of ATP, especially in brain, can cause coma or death. Such syndrome is called as Wernicke-Korsakoff syndrome. Is syndrome ko hum Wernicke-Korsakoff syndrome kehte hain. Any doubt that you have? Such type of syndrome is commonly called as the Wernicke-Korsakoff syndrome. Koi doubt hai, koi problem hai, agar koi problem hai to puch sakte hain aap. Such type of syndrome is called as Wernicke-Korsakoff syndrome. Okay, now see this. This enzyme thiamine is involved in the transfer of reactions, in the transfer of groups. So while the transfer of group is taking place, it serves as a thiamine pyrophosphate. It provides the energy that would be required for the interconversion of one molecule to another. Glyceraldehyde-3-phosphate getting converted into ribose-5-phosphate. It is involved in the pyruvate dehydrogenation reaction. Thiamine pyrophosphate serves the interconversion of pyruvate to acetyl coenzyme. And all these reactions are being catalyzed. See this. The deficiency of thiamine pyrophosphate will lead to the condition that is referred to as beriberi. Now, what is this beriberi? In the case of the beriberi arises in the condition, in the places where polished rice or polished wheat is being taken into diet, because the vitamin is present at the outer covering of the cereal grains, and this will cause vomiting. This will cause vomiting, convulsions if not treated, and can even lead to death. Or is it death bhi ho sakti hai? It can lead to dry skin, irritability, disordered thinking, progressive paralysis, etc. Wernicke-Korsakoff syndrome is being caused in the case of chronic alcoholism. When a person is drinking chronic amount of alcohol, then such type of alcoholist can develop the Wernicke-Korsakoff syndrome, a thiamine deficiency state characterized by loss of memory, ataxia, rhythmic to and fro motion of the eyeball, nystagmus. Okay, so such type of conditions can take place. Another one which is referred to as niacin, which is the important component of NAD positive and NADP positive. You can see this. The nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide can get converted into nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide phosphate in the process of phosphorylation. NAD positive kiske andar convert ho sakta hai? NADP positive ke andar, in the case of phosphorylation, and this phosphorylation takes place in the presence of ATP molecule. Okay, now this NADP positive is being biosynthesized, is being used as a energy equivalent in the reactions catalyzed in HMP pathway, fatty acid biosynthesis, NAD is being used in the case of cellular respiration. The mitochondria always keep its NAD concentration very high. Mitochondria hamesha NAD to NADH plus H positive ka ratio kitna rakhti hai? Mitochondria always keeps the NAD to NADH plus H positive ratio very high. NADH plus H positive ratio very high. It keep it as high as 100 times. Whereas when you talk about NADP positive and then you talk about NADPH plus H positive, NADPH plus H positive, then the opposite is true. Here, NADPH concentration is being kept 100 times is to 1. Okay? As compared to the NADP positive. Idhar ulta hota hai. NADPH ki concentration zyada rakhi jati hai, and this takes place in the case of cytosol. It occurs in cytosol. Whereas this occurs in mitochondria. Aisa isliye, kyunki mitochondria ka environment kaisa hota hai? The mitochondria always has an environment that is oxidizing. Oxidizing environment. Whereas the cytosol environment is always reducing. Its environment is always reducing. Okay. Is this clear to you all? Okay. So this is niacin. This is how niacin catalyzes the reactions. Now just clearing all the annotations in front of you. Have you noted this point? If you have not noted it, kindly note it down. Agar nahi likha hai, toh likh lijiye, please. Aapke mind mein koi question hai, toh aap pooch sakte hain. If you have any question in your mind, you can ask me. बहुत स्पीड में जा रहे हैं. Okay. ठीक है, मैं थोड़ा स्लो करता हूँ. अगर आपको ये लग रहा है मैं बहुत तेज जा रहा हूँ, I should slow it down. Okay. So please do always tell me now. Anybody feel anything now? You just tell me. You just inform me. See, beta, actually, me this is a topic in which very less number of questions are being asked. So I was thinking. Why not to go in speed? ठीक है, but मैं regulate कर लेता हूँ. अभी आप इन्हें लिख लीजिए पहले, उसके आगे हम बात आगे करते हैं. ठीक है, बता दिया करो, उसमें कोई problem नहीं है. If you think that I am going in speed, please just inform me. Okay? This is how the reaction is going to take place. Is this clear now? Is this clear? Anybody has any question? Okay, so no question. Now I can move forward. Okay? No questions. Now, I must delete this particular part. And now I must move towards the next vitamin. But before that, let us look at the clinical indications of the deficiency of niacin. Whenever the deficiency of niacin is going to take place, then it will cause pellagra. Okay? Pellagra. Pellagra is a disease which is being characterized by 3Ds. ये क्या है? एक 3D disease है. मैं इसे बोलता हूँ हमेशा 3D disease. यानी कि pellagra हो जाता है अगर niacin आपने कम लिया है तो. So if you have consumed less amount of niacin in your food material, then what is going to happen? Then you are going to have pellagra. In the case of pellagra, there are 3Ds: dermatitis, dementia and diarrhea. So dermatitis means the dermis becomes damaged. That means the skin becomes damaged. Skin kya hoti hai? Wo rough ho jati hai. Diarrhea, the stomach becomes matlab stomach kharab ho jata hai, pet kharab ho jata hai, and the person has to go towards the bathroom again and again. And the third one is referred to as the dementia. Dimag kharab ho jata hai. तो पेलेग्रा एक ऐसी बीमारी जिसमें तीन चीजें खराब हो जाती हैं, स्किन खराब हो जाती है, पेट खराब हो जाता है और दिमाग खराब हो जाता है. एंड इफ लेफ्ट अनट्रीटेड इट लीड्स टू डेथ. हमारे कई स्टूडेंट्स का दिमाग खराब हो गया है, डिमेंशिया, वो सब चीजें भूल जाते हैं. इन दिस कंडीशन दे यूज्ड टू फॉरगेट एवरीथिंग. डायरिया, उनका पेट खराब हो जाता है एग्जाम से पहले, और उनकी स्किन खराब हो गई है. देन यू माइट बी सफरिंग फ्रॉम द डिजीज दैट इज रेफर टू एज नाइसिन डेफिशिएंसी. ओके, नाउ मूविंग फॉरवर्ड. नाउ मूविंग फॉरवर्ड, राइबोफ्लेविन. देखो इसके अंदर तो कुछ है ही नहीं बेटा, नाइसिन के अंदर पेलेग्रा हो जाता है. पेलेग्रा को हम 3D डिसीज कहते हैं, डिमेंशिया. दैट मींस इन द मेमोरी लेस, डायरिया, द लूज मोशन टेक्स प्लेस एंड डिमेंशिया. आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू डर्मेटाइटिस, द स्किन इंफेक्शंस बिगन टू ट्रीट टेक प्लेस एंड अल्टीमेटली इट विल लीड टू डेथ. सो द नेक्स्ट वन इज रेफर टू एज विटामिन बी टू. विटामिन बी टू which is referred to as the riboflavin. The two biological active form of the vitamin B2, that is riboflavin, is referred to as FAD and FMN. Iski do biological active form hoti hai beta, flavin mononucleotide and another one is referred to as flavin adenine dinucleotide. So these are the two biological active forms of this particular compound, FMN and FAD. One is FMN, you can look here, this is FMN. Another one is referred to as FAD, flavin adenine dinucleotide. So this is also involved in the transfer of hydrogen or the transfer of electrons. Okay, ye bhi reduce ho sakta hai aur ye bhi oxidize ho sakta hai. You always know that FAD gets converted into FADH plus H positive, or FADH2 can again be metabolized to form FAD positive. So it can get reduced, it can get oxidized also. So there are several different types of reaction that are being taking place along with this particular molecule. Next point, so you can look here,
it is involved in the transfer of molecules.
The deficiency include symptoms, again include dementia, memory loss or chilosis, fishing at the center of the corner of the mouth. At the corner of the mouth, a skin fold began to accumulate. Then it is referred to as chilosis. Okay, but that's all over. The next is referred to as biotin. What do you mean by biotin? Biotin is a vitamin that catalyzes carboxylation reactions. Biotin ek aisa vitamin hota hai jo carboxylation reactions ko catalyze karta hai. It has the ability to catalyze the carbon dioxide transport. Biotin is a coenzyme in carboxylation reaction in which it serves as a carrier for activated carbon dioxide. So it is a molecule that can have the ability to transfer the carbon dioxide. So there is a site for CO2 attachment, okay, over the biotin. And this biotin can transfer the CO2 molecule directly. Biotin directly CO2 molecule ko transfer kar sakta hai. So as it has the ability to bind to the carbon dioxide molecule, so it can directly transfer the carbon dioxide molecules from one side to another. Now, raw egg white contains a glycoprotein that is referred to as avidin. Egg ke white mein glycoprotein hoti hai jiska naam hota hai avidin, which tightly bonds to biotin and prevents its absorption from the intestine. So if the egg white protein avidin binds to biotin, it will prevent the accumulation or the absorption of biotin from the intestine. If it will prevent the absorption of biotin from the intestine, it will lead to biotin deficiency in the body. Another important point is that biotin remains linked with the epsilon amino group of lysine residue, leading to the formation of a isopeptide bond. See this, biotin is covalently bound to the epsilon amino group of the lysine residue in a biotin dependent enzyme. And here, the bond which is being formed is referred to as an isopeptide bond. Yahan par jo bond banta hai CO aur NH ke beech mein, this is referred to as isopeptide bond. What do you mean by isopeptide bond? Isopeptide bond is a bond which is being formed in between the molecules in such a manner. Isopeptide bond. It is a bond which is being formed in molecules in such a manner in which the amino acid side chain and the other amino acid main chain is involved. When one amino acid side chain, amino acid side chain and another amino acid main chain, and another amino acid main chain is involved. Another amino acid main chain is involved. Then the procedure is referred to as, then the bond which is being formed is called as isopeptide bond. इस समय जो बॉन्ड बनता है उसका नाम होता है आइसोपेप्टाइड बॉन्ड. इज दिस क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू? ओके, नाउ द नेक्स्ट कंपाउंड इज पेंटोथेनिक एसिड एंड द लास्ट वाटर सॉल्युबल विटामिन. ओके, सो जस्ट फिनिशिंग इट आउट. सो द पेंटोथेनिक एसिड इज अ कंपाउंड ऑफ द कोएंजाइम ए कैटेगरी. ओके, सो इट इज इन्वॉल्वड इन अ कंपाउंड इन द फैटी एसिड सिंथेसिस रिएक्शन एंड सर्व एज द कंपोनेंट ऑफ द एसाइल कोरियर प्रोटीन. So pantothenic acid is a component of the acyl carrier protein, also referred to as ACP. So acyl ACP molecule can be produced in the presence of the pantothenic acid. Pantothenic acid fatty acid biosynthesis ke andar work karta hai. Okay, so all the different egg and liver and yeast are all the different sources of the pantothenic acid. With this we have finished all the water soluble vitamins. Tomorrow we would be talking about the fat soluble vitamins and then finishing off the topic of vitamins. Okay, just to inform you that towards the end of the chapter there is a chart which is given. You must have a look at that particular chart. I would be providing that chart in the form of a photograph to you all so that you can look forward, but you have to memorize that particular chart. This is the chart that is being shown to you. This is the chart. Okay, and you have to memorize this particular chart. That's all for today. Hope you found it interesting. We would be meeting just within 15 minutes in another lecture of genetics. And in today's lecture, we'd be talking about linkage crossing and other different types of phenomena in the case of genetics. So please do not miss the lecture. And if you are watching the same things over the videos, please do like, share, subscribe to the channel. That's all for today. If you want to ask something, just wait for a second and then you can ask it. Okay, just a minute.